It is another action-packed weekend, and we've got WCW action. Tony, Larry, thank you very much. A veteran making his way into the ring, Kendall Windham, himself a second-generation wrestler in the pride of Sweetwater, Texas. And he's going to be in there against the young man really making a mark or attempting to do so, Iron Mike. Mr. Manny Fernandez is his opponent today on Worldwide.
Well, Lee, a real contrast here in terms of experience. You mentioned the second-generation competitor, Kendall Windham, on his way to the ring. You notice, I'm sure his father would be proud because he is sporting the big black glove. It was so reminiscent through the years of his father's in-ring attire. We speak of none other than Big Black Jack Mulligan.
Yep.
Kendall Windham to face Manny Fernandez. And Manny Fernandez has been around our sport for a couple of years. But in terms of his in-ring experience, it just pales in comparison to the veteran Kendall Windham.
Kendall Windham has not only readapted his style, but I think he has gone well out of his way to get into the gym, work very, very hard, and almost recreate himself physically. If you remember when Kendall Windham first came out into the sport, although he looked good, he looked more like a gymnast or a swimmer. You had that lean,
very
lanky
sleek
body. Yeah, very sleek. But he bulked up, put on some weight, hit the iron real, real hard. And he's a new Kendall Windham with a whole new attitude as well.
Well, I think Kendall Windham realizes that if he's going to compete in 1998 with the big boys of professional wrestling, then he had to turn it up a notch, especially in that physical department. And just taking one look at Kendall Windham, it looks to me like over the course of the past year or so, he has probably put on in the neighborhood of about 50 or 60 pounds.
You know, I noticed the bigger men in our sport today, and I draw an analogy to the bigger men in football, like the linemen, for example. You think of the old linemen, they were just these big lumbering dinosaur guys. Same with a lot of the old wrestlers. But now, you look at the linemen in the NFL and some of the big men at WCW, these are very fast men. A Kendall Windham, or let's just go to the top of the heap, a Goldberg, as big as he is, man, he is fast. When he hits you with that spear, you know you've been stuck, pal.
Let's take it one notch further, just really to accentuate your point. Let's look at a wrestler like the Giant.
Oh, yeah.
The largest athlete in pro sports. The guy is 7'4", he's over 550 pounds, and he's doing drop kicks off the top rope.
Yep.
If that doesn't really just exemplify how much the heavyweights and the super heavyweights have had to change their game plan just to really exist and to have success at this point in professional wrestling, I don't think that anything does.
It certainly speaks to the athleticism of where the big boys play and the big boys play in WCW. And let's not discount the New World Order, certainly. And you know the Four Horsemen, they're back indeed. And they've got a big man, Mr. Steve Mongo McMichael. Man, can he come off that defensive line?
You're talking about groups and factions in professional wrestling. Don't forget the newest. Speaking of the LWO, the Latino World Order, headed up by Eddie Guerrero. They are certainly making their impact felt as well.
Well, that's just speed exemplified right there. You hook up a group of the luchadors, especially the premier luchadors like Eddie Guerrero has managed to recruit. Man, they are strong. They are fast. And like you said, their voice is being heard loud and clear throughout WCW, and I wonder if it's being heard equally loud in the executive offices of one Mr. Eric Bischoff.
Well, that was really the main purpose behind the formation of the LWO originally. If you remember back, it was Eddie Guerrero's problems that he had with Eric Bischoff,
yep,
that the Latin wrestlers, that the luchadors weren't getting their proper due, weren't getting the breaks that other wrestlers from WCW,
wow,
and the NWO were, and Manny Fernandez springs off the ropes. Forearm
Look
smash
the
neck, scoop and a slam.
We talk about power and speed. Manny Fernandez coming out of a couple of atomic drops issued by Kendall Windham, and Fernandez all over Windham now.
Field him out of the corner. The size and weight of Kendall Windham makes it difficult for Manny Fernandez to get up in a move like a suplex.
Blocked
the second time.
Man, that was a great plan B. You could just see the wheels turning in Kendall Windham's head. All right, I got two blocks now. Where do I go?
Able to adapt on the fly. Yep. Cover on the clothesline.
I'll tell you what, not only did Kendall Windham out-muscle Manny Fernandez, but I think this is a real good example, Mike, of how Kendall Windham really just outsmarted and outfought Manny Fernandez in this match.
Able to change it in mid-move. The attempt at the suplex by Manny Fernandez was reversed into that beautiful swinging neck breaker. As we take another look, there you see the backdrop suplex delivered by Kendall Windham. The running lariat, left arm extended, took him off of his feet, and the easy cover in the three count.
Man, this is a great WCW World. This is almost too much show. Don't go away. We got more action coming up on Worldwide.